Assalamualaikum and good day to all. This presentation highlight my research paper entitled Crowd Control Using Deep Learning for my final year project. A crowd is defined as a large gathering of people for a specific reason, such as concert events, sports events, and political gatherings. Crowd counting is defined as estimating or counting the number of people in an image or video. At first, techniques for crowd counting are divided into three categories, which are detection-based, regression-based, and density estimation-based. Over the time, might include deep learning, CNN-based technique demonstrate even greater aptitude and outperform standard technique on the crowd counting task. Detection-based technique count the number of individuals in the scene by detecting each individual. This method works well in low-density crowd scene, with few people blocking each other. However, when the density level of crowd situations grows, they perform poorly. Since detection-based approach cannot be adapted to highly congested scenes, researchers try to deploy regression-based approach to use for generating low-level information. The density estimation model investigates a novel method for predicting crowd density by mapping local future patches to the associated people density maps. The total number of individuals is equal to the integral over the whole density map of the input picture. Most recent CNN-based approach use a fully convolutional CNN architecture to map a crowd image to the density map, and the crowd count is obtained by summing across all the pixels in the predicted map. Overcrowding is common during large events such as movies, games, sports, and concerts. There is a risk to public safety during such large-scale public gatherings. A crowd will grow in no time, and it can become very difficult for the organizer to manage the crowd. Problems like abnormal behavior or even stampeders may occur in such situations. Major examples of crowd disaster are the Love Parade disaster in Germany. Therefore, it is necessary to have an intelligent crowd counting system to prevent abnormal behavior, stampeders, and blockage in large-scale public gatherings. This research is carried out in order to apply the suitable deep learning algorithm for crowd counting using one of the CNN-based crowd counting approach. Following that, this research is further developed by developing a crowd counting system in Google Colab using the Python programming language. Finally, this research is evaluated by performing a performance analysis on the crowd counting system using public dataset. In this experiment, the SFA-net method is applied as the deep learning algorithm. The SFA-net architecture consists of a VGG16 backbones and dual-road multi-scale fusion network with attention, which are density map pass and attention map pass. VGG16 backbone is used to extract multi-scale characteristics for input picture initially. The density map pass employs concatenate and upsample to fuse multi-scale features, whereas the attention map pass employs an attention model to highlight head area in order to deal with background noise and non-uniformity in crowd cluster. The first 13 layers from the convolution 1-1 to convolution 5-3 are involved to output future maps which size 1/2, 1/4, 1/8 and 1/16 of the original input size. Four source layers, which are convolution 2-2, convolution 3-3, convolution 4-3 and convolution 5-3, which represent multi-scale futures and multi-level semantic information, will be concatenated by both density map paths and attention map paths. For the back end, the attention map path and density map path is applied. The attention map path of SFNet has the similar structure with density map path. Both output probability map is used to indicate head probability in each pixel of the density feature map. Every 1 times 1 convolution before the 3 times 3 is used to reduce the computational complexity. Due to previous 3 upsample layers, the final high resolution feature maps can be retrieved with 1/2 size of the original input. Besides that, the Shanghai Tech Part B dataset was used to train the SFANet method in this experiment. The Shanghai Tech dataset is a collection of data for relatively large-scale crowd counting. The collection contains 1,198 pictures and 330,165 labeled heads. It's one of the most significant datasets, since the number of recorded heads is large enough for planning and evaluating. The figure shows the result of the SFANet method's performance with the Shanghai Tech Part B dataset. The attention map is on the right side while the density map is on the middle side. The experiment utilized different settings from SFANet, which is a pre-trained method in which the epoch value was set to 100 and batch size to 8. The results show that the SFANet method is capable of locating head regions and regressing the head count. In this experiment, mean absolute error, MAE, was used to evaluate the performance of the SFANet's algorithm. The MAE value obtained in this experiment was 8.5. The MAE value differed from SFANet with pre-trained method, which was 18.8% difference. However, the result was greater than other methods as shown in table. In conclusion, this research has established the main objective of using the suitable deep learning algorithm for crowd counting, which is the SFANet algorithm. SFANet is one of the CNN-based crowd counting approach. It also demonstrates a strong ability to locate head region and regress the head count. The MAE value obtained in this experiment is higher than the other methods. As a result, the research main objective has been fulfilled. The second purpose of this research, which was to create a crowd counting system using the Google Colab platform, was also accomplished. To use Google Colab, we must first learn how to write program in Python. After successfully studying the language, the system was modified using the code obtained from the GitHub website. As a result, the goal of developing a crowd counting system using Google Colab was reached. Finally, the third objective of evaluating the performance of the crowd counting system was completed successfully. The SFN algorithm's performance was evaluated using the Shanghai Tech Part B dataset. This is due to the image in Shanghai Tech Part B dataset have varying densities of people. Thus, the goal of the objective was accomplished. In the future research, we aim to modify this approach so it can be applied to CCTV through real-time video, such as CCTV located at shopping malls. Then, the algorithm will be upgraded with the alert information to notify the user if the location is overcrowded. That's all for me. Thank you.